The New York Rangers still have a chance to re-sign Vladimir Tarasenko, but they must make this one move, and it is a must if they want to bring back Tarasenko, and that is moving on from Barclay Gaudreau. There's no other options really possible, like at all, to bring him back if we don't trade Gaudreau. There's not a possibility unless he's taking like an 800K deal, and you know, it's not going to happen. He's not going to take 800K. I don't think he's going to pull Blake Wheeler here and really help us out with that, you know, 800K deal for 1 year worth up to 1.1. I don't think he's going to do that. So, obviously, I think, you know, if we can bring him back and we can trade Gaudreau, I would love that. But is Gaudreau going to cost us some stuff, or are we going to get something back? I don't really know. I don't think we're going to be able to get something back for him, but I mean, if we could, that'd be absolutely insane, but I don't think so. I think we'll probably have to give up a pick. And if you think about the Patrick Nemeth deal, the last kind of deal that we had to, you know, trade some picks off to get rid of a big contract, it was like a 1 year deal, right? So that is kind of interesting, right? It was kind of interesting. Their AAVs were fairly close, but it was one year deal, right? But obviously Nemeth was a lot worse, right? Barclay Gaudreau was actually a usable, like, you know, third line kind of guy. I think that's where you kind of he's good for. I think you can put him on the third line. Maybe not if you're winning a Stanley Cup. If you're winning a Stanley Cup, you want him on the fourth. But I do think that he can be a third liner on a decent amount of teams around the league, especially some bottom-tier teams. Like maybe a team like Anaheim is willing to take him on for like a third-rounder or a second-rounder, a third-rounder prospect, a fourth-rounder prospect, or something like that at a fairly cheap kind of what we're giving up. But they're willing to take on that contract at 3.6, help him get to the floor, as well as, you know, just bringing a veteran guy who can be a solid body. But obviously he does have a bit of a no trade clause, and that's kind of an unfortunate part as well. As you know, Barclay Gaudreau has a modified no trade clause, so he's a 15 team no trade list, so nearly half the league is going to be on that list. So, you know, is Anaheim on there, for example? I don't know if Anaheim's really interested. I just kind of thought that was a realistic possibility, considering they did overpay for guys like Alec Killorn and Radko Gudas. So maybe they would be looking to bring in another guy, kind of a bit overpaid, but a good veteran guy who can help, you know, lead the young guys and be a solid kind of second liner right now, or whatever, or third line, or whatever they need right now, and be a good PK guy, a good veteran guy, just to help the mentor the young guys. So I don't think that's a possibility. A team like Anaheim could be in on him, but I'm not quite sure. Honestly, they did overpay for guys like Gudas and Killorn, like I said, so maybe they are willing to take on a bit bigger of a deal, a bit of an overpaid guy, and bring him on, get another pick or two, or pick a prospect, whatever it is, and you know, they can just have a veteran guy in there, and obviously have him locked up for the next few years, because they're not going to be big spenders for a while anyways. I mean, they're still quite a few years out. Well, like a few years out. I'll say at least like two or three probably still even before they really make an impact and they're really spending big money. So I do think it's definitely a realistic possibility the Rangers could be a team, or Anaheim could be a team the Rangers are looking to trade Gaudreau to. But there's definitely a few teams that could be in on him for sure. I do think there's going to be a couple. I just don't think there's going to be a ton, right, obviously. But with that 15-team no trade list, like I said, it cuts pretty much half the league and like they can't trade him to. So it definitely makes that kind of tough, but he's not a bad player at all. I mean, last year with the Rangers had 31 points, 11 goals, 20 assists in 82 games played. We know he's a good penalty killer, can play pretty much any position on forward, like center, left wing, right wing, pretty much anywhere. He's just a great versatile kind of guy, a really good just team player, gives it his all. You know, he'll battle in the corners, he'll PK, he'll do that, all that good stuff. So he's a solid two-way player, good two-way forward, but you know, is there going to be a move available out there? We'll have to wait and see. Or are the Rangers going to keep him? That is definitely possible, but I think the Rangers, if Tarasenko is willing to come back, I think that then you try and look for a move, because bringing back Tarasenko would be absolutely fantastic for this team and definitely really load up this team with some just great value. I mean, just tons of firepower up front, obviously still having a pretty solid decor as well. Vesna, caliber goalie, and Igor. This team will be right back ready to compete for a Stanley Cup. And you can also make your moves at the deadline, adding in some other guys. Maybe you even re-sign Kane in like November, whatever, when he's coming back. And, you know, he comes on like an 800K deal or $1 million deal or something like that, and you can figure that out too. That'd be absolutely insane. But, you know, just thinking things here, it's definitely possible. We could be making moves later on in the season as well, even if we do bring back Tarasenko. But he can be a 30 to 40 point kind of guy. If he's playing on like a team like the Ducks, where he's getting a lot more opportunity, definitely could put up a 40 piece. I could definitely see that. But overall, he's just a good two-way forward and definitely a guy who I'd love to see the Rangers bring back. Tarasenko, on the other hand, though, he had a fantastic, you know, run with the Rangers once he got here. Like the best thing in the world, but definitely quite solid. You know, 31 games played, 21 points, 8 goals, 13 assists. Very solid numbers there. You know, playing like 15 minutes and 55 seconds a night, not bad at all. And only had one goal, one power play goal, and four power play assists. So, you know, only 5 power play points, not too bad at all. had a 16 even strength points in 31 games played. It's not awful once came to the Rangers. And obviously as well had 4 points in 7 games played in the playoffs, 3 goals, 1 assist. Not bad. He didn't do too bad. Unfortunately, some of the guys did, though, and that was kind of why we lost. But overall, though, I thought he played pretty good in the playoffs and in the regular season, was one of the guys who at least did decent in the playoffs for the most part. And overall, though, I do think that bringing back Tarasenko would be absolutely massive for this team. I definitely am a big fan of trying to do that. But like I said, we'd have to move Barclay Gaudreau. There's no way around it. Right now, we have $6.175 million. And obviously, we still have to re-sign Lafreniere and Keandre Miller. So that's going to eat up all that money pretty much. I mean, Lafreniere can take a 2 year at like $2 million deal, or kind of like what Capo took at like 2 year, 2.1. Maybe that's what Lafreniere is going to take, and that's definitely possible. And if he does, that'd be great, because that leaves $4 million for Keandre. And if you get Keandre at like 3 years, $4 million, or like 2 years, $4 million, that is definitely a realistic possibility. But anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Hope you guys have enjoyed. If you guys have, please smash the like button and definitely comment down below your guys' thoughts on the range of potentially trading Gaudreau and bringing in Vladimir Tarasenko and re-signing him on a one-year deal at $4 million or less, because anything more than that wouldn't be possible. Thanks for watching, and see ya.